The film that is being explained is Warm Bodies, and it is about the zombies. An airport is viewed as the movie starts, where some zombies are cleaning the place. It is not the fact that human beings have hired them, they have rather a separate world which they continue to clean. Another thing with which they have familiarity is food. It means how they have to quench their appetite. It is a separate part of the city where zombies reside, because a few human beings transformed into zombies with a cause some years ago, then human beings built a wall amid their city. Zombies were confined to the opposite side of the wall, and on the other side, there were all other human beings who were not infected by the zombies. Nor they had transformed into the zombies, they had been living as such for the 7 to 8 years. A boy comes on the scene at the airport, which is the site of zombies. He is a zombie in actuality, but it was appearing that he had been lovely when he was human being. He is indulged in his thought. What is he thinking? No one knows. Because zombies had not ability to express their emotions, because they had no ability to speak out, they were pale, because they had not healthy red blood cells, nor their hearts used to throb. Because they all were dead, and their most favorite food was human beings, and they all zombies used to walk too slowly, now they were hungry. So they wanted to move to the opposite side of the city. So that they may eat the human beings after attacking them, but they cannot cross the wall because it is strongest. It was good thing because human beings were not interested in facing the zombies, otherwise, they transformed into the zombies. There was inhabited another creature which looked like the skeletons, because their skin had been contracted after their death. Their bones used to look crystal clear. So they were called bonies. They used to never harm the zombies but wanted to eat the human beings, so the human beings used to keep themselves away from them. A zombie about which it was told in the beginning, that he is probing something and also looking shrewd, because he was attempting to recall his pastime. But he was unable to recollect the memories, he just remembered when he was alive. As his name was started with the alphabet, R, so he will also be called R. In this movie, he continued to probe as he is attempting to reveal, how will he transform into a zombie? The matter of fact is this, he wanted to become human being. Because he was disturbed from this life. Neither he could speak nor he eat anything except human beings, it was just their life in which they used to walk slowly, he had trust in human beings. So he gets in the airplane while walking, there he plays music. There is also another zombie, he is a best friend of R. Now they all zombies decide, making a team, that we will go to the human beings so we may quench our appetite, eating them, but it happens as human beings are also very worried in the opposite direction of the city, because the half part of the city was situated in that direction, there were also their stocks as food, medicine and commodities which was their requirements. But they could not go there. Now the human beings also build their team, which is of youth including a few males and females, so they may collect the stock, moving in the direction of zombies. Now they all move to the opposite direction of the wall, they enter a pharmacy. They did not know that zombies have also come in this direction. But they soon sense that zombies are also in this pharmacy. Human beings immediately begin to fire the gun on the zombies. Then, R observes that a girl is also firing the gun on them. Her name is Julie. And she is also the major character of this movie. R begins to stare at her. As his past is connected with her. R is trying to recollect the memories, but one who does not his name, how can he remember the past? He is indulged in this thought that a human being begins to attack him. R eats his brain, killing him at the moment. Here the interesting fact is this, that zombie's memories had started to restore after eating the brain of human. He directly moves to Julie. At the first time, he utters her name, because he had eaten the human brain for the first time after being transformed into the zombie. When he notices that other zombies are going to attack Julie, then he smears the blood on the face of Julie, and he catches her hand so the scent of Julie may not reach the zombies, and they feel that she is also a zombie like them. R brings Julie along with him towards his city, then R brings Julie into the airplane and he starts to take care of her as before. He offers her a blanket, but Julie is very afraid from him. Now R was a zombie. There was no guarantee of zombies when they harmed the human beings. R had no ability to speak, but he was also developing the language skill from the time Julie had come. He says to Julie, "Don't be afraid." He sits beside Julie, offering her blanket, and he begins to look at her. Here the heartbeat of R works. It was a weird, because zombies' hearts do not throb, so it was indication that R may be transformed into the human being. Because his changing of bodies were the indication of this thing, Julie is still frightening and she is not getting an idea to escape from here, because she knew that it is like to invite the death while living among zombies, she says to R. After a time, I am feeling appetite. R. goes to take food for her. And she wanted the same thing. She instantly gets off the airplane. She starts to run. But she notices that zombies have started to chase her, she hides under the airplane. Meanwhile, R. also approaches there, he asks her, what happened? Why did you come outside? He trains her, you will have to walk slowly if you want to live with zombie. As zombies walk so you may not create any difference, then Julie starts to walk as such that no zombie suspects her. In this way, Julie and R. get in the airplane. Julie takes food and says to R. I want to go from here. R. says to her, stop. There are zombies outside and they will not let you go as such. If I let you go then you might be stopped by those zombies. And you may not alive today, just stay for some days so they get familiarity with your face, then you may go now from here. Here, Julie feels relaxation. It is good for me that I am not going to be harmed by R. Now they used to pass a very good time with each other, they had befriended again. Julie was not recognizing R after his transformation into zombie, but R had something in his memory. So he tries to please her in this way, they also go for a car ride. One day R's zombie friend senses, who wanted to eat the human beings, killing them, those hungry bonies are moving towards her, then R takes Julie along with him, catching her hand, but three more zombies appear from the front side, who are going to attack them. Another car which hits these zombies, there was no another person in the car but R's that friend, he says to his friend, I am just doing this favor for you. He makes them seat in the car. And he says, this car cannot be driven away, but I will drop you to a vehicle in which you may drive to a house, he does the same. When R's friend drops both of them there, there are a number of zombies who begin to attack them, but R catches the hand of Julie. Seeing it, zombies are unable to harm her, because this relation between zombies and human beings was very powerful. When R caught the hand of Julie, then zombies had got an idea, because they had not been zombies like the zombies existed in past, the transition was appearing in them. Taking the car from there, Julie and R drives to that house. Night falls, so Julie wanted to take rest, but she feels that there are a few cars out of the house. And it is the police car. There is also military colonel with them, who was anyone else but the father of Julie, who had come there in search of Julie. But Julie does not go down, because she knew it that her father caught her sight. If she goes outside, then they will also search for R and kill them, but Julie did not want it, so she lays on the bed silently. Because she could not do with R as such, R had also rescued her for several times, then R tells her, do you know that I had killed your friend? Then Julie says, yeah, I know that he is no more. But I did not know that you had killed her. R hands over the wristwatch of her friend. Now Julie says to R zombie, why do you eat the human beings? Do you not feel bad? Then R tells, human beings are our food. We cannot survive without them, as you take food. Can you survive without it? Then this discussion is over between them and R sleeps here, and you will be astonished knowing it that R sleeps for the first time as a zombie after many years, and he dreams of Julie again. But he notices after waking up that Julie is nowhere. He gets worried. He checks, going downstairs, there is also not car. Then he understands that Julie has left from here. She had surely disliked it that I killed her friend. Being dejected, he begins to come outside. Here it is noticed that he had started to walk fast as before, because changes were occurring in his body which are in the human beings. Then it starts rain. R begins to feel cold, which is not felt by the zombies. It was also an indication that he is transforming from zombies. He starts to walk straight, thinking, I will have to forget Julie. She is human being who acted right. She was not an insane who starts to live with zombies. Then he notices that there is his zombie friend before him, moving ahead. They talk with R. R's friend says to him, my friend, I never wanted your ill, but I want to reveal to you that our body is facing changes in the same way as you received. R's friend tells him, do you know, I also dreamt through which I am remembering my past. R tells his friend, yeah, I also dreamt. Look, you will also be feeling cold now, I am feeling. And this change has occurred in us. It seems we are changing and transforming into the human being. all other zombies get excited. R's friend clears, then it is good omen. Then R's friend says, yeah, I had to reveal it to Julie, but she has gone. Can I tell her this after searching for her? I need to apologize her that I killed her friend. He shows the photo of Julie to the other zombies. Then they all move to that location of city where a giant wall is built, from where zombies can never cross it. Reaching there, they struggle hard but in vain. The R remembers something because he has eaten the brain of Julie's friend. He understands how Julie's friend used to cross this wall. He moves to the opposite side of the wall, using the same trick. Now he starts to search for the house of Julie. Finding the house of Julie, he stands at the backside of that house. Julie calls him inside instantly, glimpsing him. She asks him, how are you here? I am very pleased that you visited here. Tell me, have you not been seen by anyone? Art tells, no, I have reached here carefully. Julie says, it means that zombies has learnt the tricks. Art says to her, I wanted to apologize you. I killed your friend. Then Julie says, don't apologize. It is not your fault, all zombies commit the same. Yes, I could restrain myself to talk to you if you had deliberately did it. Afterwards, Julie also apologizes. I came here without telling you. But how could I live in the world of zombies? But it is also truth. Reaching here, I missed you. And look, you came. Then they both embrace. Then Julie and her friend say, if Colonel knew that a zombie is at their house, then they will kill him. Then they both friends start to put on to make up to R. She uses on him the cosmetics of human beings. They paint his lip with pink color to show he has blood and he is human being. He also looks like a human being after making his face up. Then they three of them plan that they will tell to Julie's father that zombies had not been bad. Changes are occurring in them. After a time, they will be transformed into the human beings. They should not be killed. Now three of them move to Julie's father Colonel together. Julie begins to suggest her father, father, don't kill the zombies now, they are transforming into the human beings. Changes are occurring in them. Colonel asks her, how do you know? I am not going to trust in you, you are still a child. He understands that Art is not human being as he catches his sight, because he had the ability to recognize the difference between zombies and human beings. He points the gun on the zombie R. But Julie's friend also points gun on him from the backside. She threatens, uncle, I will kill you if you targeted him. You are wronging. Taking the advantage of it, Julie takes R along with her. Then R brings Julie at that place where other zombies are waiting for them. Then R's friend reveals to them, there is a big threat. Bonis are also coming from the backside, who want to end you. And you also know that military is also after you, which will soon arrive here. Your both lives are at risk. Escape from here. We will encounter them. There is a glass roof where they are present. Police had approached there. Julie and R are timely escaped from there. But the zombies are left behind. Police officers soon descend while breaking the rude glass. They begin to attack zombies. Meantime, military also approaches there. They get the mouth-watering condition as they notice human beings and bonis there. Now zombies rescue the human beings when a number of bonis are attacking a military officer. Then a zombies rescues him. And he makes him stand, catching his hand. Then that military officer is inspired from that zombie. He had known it that they are getting a positive change. When other military officers notice that zombies are fighting with the bonis, and they are rescuing the human beings. Then they say them, we are also with you. Because they themselves had witnessed this transition. But Colonel had not trust, till now, that zombies are changing. He was still determined on this that, zombies have to kill at any cost. On the other side, it is seen that R and Julie are going, at the same time, bonis are nearly to attack them. Julie is standing with R on the tall building. When they check, there is no way left to escape in surroundings. Then R observes a pool at the below side with the excess of water. R suggests to Julie, we will have to jump into it so we may rescue our lives. Now R jumps into the water, catching Julie. There is excess of water, so R goes into the depth of water. Julie is safe and sound. When R appears from the water, then Colonel has also reached there till that time, who fires his gun on R's shoulder. But Julie appears before and says, father, are you not understanding? R has changing now. You will not continue firing more. Otherwise, I am not going to take side from the front. Then they all observe that R's shoulder was bleeding, where he had been shot. What did it indicate? Yeah, because he has turned into human being, because there are not the red blood cells in the zombie's body. Noticing it, Julie is extremely excited. When Julie's father Colonel witnesses the blood, that zombies are changing then they don't kill R, and they send the message to all military officers that zombies should not be killed. Now zombies and human beings together start to kill those bonies. And they take care of them too much so the bonies may not get ability to attack them. Due to this, bonies are died with starvation, while human beings and zombies have been killed the other remaining bonies. Now the situation of this place was getting better now. There had left a few zombies who had not transformed into the human beings completely. There is no suspicion that they had turned into the human beings within the days. The built wall in the city is dropped down, because zombies had transformed into the human beings. All are very satisfied and live together. They have no threat of anything. Julie and R are very excited with each other. This movie gives a moral that, we can cure any human being or anything with affection and belief. This inspiring movie completes on this scene. Thanks for watching.